Good morning, class 12. So we have discussed, as you know, that we have discussed all the pre-fertilization events till the pollination. So today in this class we are going to study about the fertilization in detail. As you can see, it's a simple word, looks like that only fertilization, but no, it is a complicated process which includes number of steps, and today we will discuss those steps one by one in detail. So if we talk about fertilization was discovered and explained by scientist Strasburger, right? So first step which comes in the fertilization is interaction. As you know that there is ovules are present inside the ovary. So it is not ovules which directly interact with pollen, it is pistil which interacts with the pollen. So that is why first step is pollen pistil interaction. Let's see first the diagram. As you can see, I have drawn a big diagram of stigma here and the style, right? Then now what happen is, here is our pollen with the intine and exine. Now what happen here is, you know that a particular species or particular pollen always germinate on stigma. So first step is identification. Genetically both pollen and pistil, they should be competent toward the each other. They should be specific according to each other. After genetically identification, what happens that this stigma, as you can see here, small red dots. So this stigma releases a few secretions. These secretions contain water plus sugar. So this liquid or sugar plus water, which is released by stigma, it is taken in by the pollen, and from the germ pore, pollen tube germinates, and this is called our second step, that is pollen tube germination. So there are few gaps. As how do you draw a pollen? So you know that this is, these are our very high resistant, that is our exine, and inner one is our intine, and few gaps are here, that is the germ pore. So from this germ pore, pollen tube will be germinates. So second step will be, after identification or pollen pistil interaction, the second point is pollen tube germination. Now sometimes it happens that usually in flowers only or in case of pollens, only one pollen tube germinates. Most common situation, those pollens in which only one pollen tube germinate, that is called monosiphonous, and if more than one pollen tube germinates, that is called polysiphonous. Clear? So one pollen tube, mono, more than one, that will we use the word poly. So next, third step is, now pollen tube has arisen, so now pollen tube germinates. So next is the growth of pollen tube. Now how many at how many stage pollen is released? Pollen always releases at, you know that in angiosperm 60% cases pollen is released at two cell stage. One is the vegetative cell, bigger one smaller generative cell, and one bigger vegetative or the tube cell, right? So how many cell stage pollen or how many gametes are there? That is the two, vegetative cell and one is the generative cell, or one, you can say, one bigger tube cell and one smaller one, that is the generative cell, right? So these two, now they are present here, and here is our exine. And as you can see now, there is the growth of pollen tube starts. And what is this? This is our stigma and style. So growth of pollen tube starts here. That is our third step, right? And which stage, how many gametes are there? Two. Because pollens, they are released at two cell stage, right? So now after formation of pollen tube has now arise. So after formation of pollen tube, generative cell, which cell? There are two cells, one is the vegetative one and one is the generative cell. Now this generative cell, this undergo into mitotic division. And one, when it undergo mitotic division, how many male gametes will be formed now? Two male gametes will be formed, right? And other will be our tube cell. One cell will be tube cell and this will be our generative cell. So this generative cell, one is tube cell and one is generative cell. So this generative cell, it undergo which division? It undergo mitotic division, right? So two male gametes are formed. So how you have to show it? First, there is a growth of pollen tube. You have to draw axine and there is our stigma and style. Now let's draw our gametes, right? How the gametes will be now look like here. Now you can see that these are our two male gametes, because how many male gametes will be formed after mitotic division? Two male gametes will be formed. And one, this tube cell, this is our tube cell, or you can mark it with another pen also. So there is a tube cell with the cytoplasmic content, right? So this is cytoplasmic content of tube cell with its nucleus. So we have two male gametes plus tube cell with its cytoplasmic content. Clear? Now we discuss that style can be of two types. One is holo, means these epidermal cells, they are present only at the corners, right? So the in between it is empty. So this type of style is known as holo style, right? So style through which pollen tube grows, it can be holo or it can be solid. So if you are not able to visualize it, so here I have drawn here these two male gametes and I have just drawn one tube cell with its cytoplasmic content with nucleus, right? So I have drawn these things here inside the pollen tube. Now the second thing is, if your style is not hollow, if it is solid, then what is happening here? If it is solid, now what will happen if it is solid? So now you can see that there is our, at the corner, the epidermal cells are present and inside the style, it is completely filled with this green color cell. These are the parenchymatous cells. So this tissue is known as conductive tissue. And here is our germination of pollen tube. So here you can see this is our tube cell with the cytoplasmic content. And here these two are our male gametes, right? So this tissue is known as now conductive tissue, and this style is solid style. And it happens that pollen tube, you can see that pollen tube grows. This pollen tube grows through this conductive tissue in the solid style. So in solid style, there are chances. Now as pollen tube is growing inside this conductive tissue, so there are chances that when it comes inside the conductive tissue, that few content can be squeezed out. So we can't afford to remove remove our content from the style. So what happened here is, to prevent this kind of situation, to so that content should not go out from the style, there is a plug or like a cap is formed inside the style, and that plug is known as Calo's plug. Now I am just drawing the our pollen tube. So here you can see these two male gametes, and here at the end of the pollen tube there is a plug is formed to prevention that no content should go out from the pollen tube. So here this is bigger one. So as the pollen tube germinates or it grows, these callous plugs, they are present at the tip of the pollen tube. So here is our cytoplasmic content or tube nucleus, right? So these two male gametes are there. So what is happening, that callous plug formation takes place, and these callous plugs basically it keep all the contents present in your style at the tip of the pollen tube, or I will say the all the content present in the pollen tube, it keeps them at the tip. So when callous plug is formed, now sometime there are three kinds of possibility when pollen tube now is going to interact with these ovules. So there are three possibilities in which pollen tube enters into ovule. Either now you can see here that there is our chalazal end and here is our micropylar end. So let's draw this now whole structure of embryo sac first, right? This is our embryo sac with the ovule. This is a thalamus on which this structure is situated, and as you can see these are integuments, and here these are integuments, and here is present our embryo sac with three antipodal cells, right? What are these? Two synergids and one large egg, right? And what is happening here? Here is our pollen tube is getting formed. So this pollen tube, we are drawing a very common situation here, that usually it reach to the micropylar end. And what are these inside the pollen tube? These are our callous plugs, right? And how many male gametes? Two male gametes. And this is our tube nucleus with the cytoplasmic content. So two possibilities are there. One is pollen tube. This pollen tube can enter through the chalazal end. This type of situation is known as chalazogamy. If pollen tube is entering through these integuments, this is called mesogamy. But if pollen tube enters through the micropylar end, which is most common situation, this is known as porogamy. So we have drawn here the entry of pollen tube through the micropylar end, which is known as porogamy, right? So in my next video I'm going to talk about that, how does this entry of pollen tube into embryo sac takes place, and how the pollen tube release its male gametes into the this embryo sac.